Everybody, welcome back. It's Charlie, SortofSurvival.com. Also have another channel I'm gonna design. It's called DesertSurvival.us, which I'm gonna put nothing but Desert Survival posts on that one. So I did a recent post on primitive weapons, making a bow. This is the bow I made recently without using a knife. I use only rocks. I'll post the link to the video there. I let it sit around in my garage for a while so the bow can season some more and get out and shoot it. And I shot at 10 yards, 15 yards, and 20 yards. I kind of paused the video so I can go get my arm guard because this bow did slap my arm a little bit. It's kind of painful. And I wanted to go down range and retrieve some arrows that I missed so I can put some more down there. I can see up to 20 yards, I didn't do too bad. This is the first time, or the second time I've shot this bow since I made it. Still has original paracord string that I put on it out there. All I did was smooth it out a little bit, and I put wrap some leather string around here to make it a little bit more comfortable. But as you can see, I'm gonna take you up here to the target and show you that this bow at 20 yards will kill. And if you're even better, you can take it back a couple more yards and shoot something bigger. But for smaller game, which is this target, simulating probably a wild pig or something at 20 yards. Also, here's another idea. If you have old combat boots or whatever, don't throw them away. You can make your own arm guard out of it. All I did was take, like you see, these are the laces. Your foot goes in this way in the boot. I use paracord for laces, and all you do is cut the boot off at the ankle, right like this, and you just put your arm through it, and for me, it fits perfect. And there's even room to tighten it up a little bit more if you got smaller arms. So this makes a good arm guard. I do use finger gloves for shooting. This string can probably be shot without these gloves because it's probably about a 25-pound pull. I measured over there, it's about 25-pound pull at 28 inches. But then again, I'm just showing you a practical use of it. So let's go down range and check out the target. Okay, there's a couple arrows on the ground where I hit the board and did hit the thing, but I can see here on the target. Let me straighten this out for you. That right there pretty much will kill whatever I was aiming at. Of course, you need a little practice. I wasn't used to shooting so low of a pound. I'm using about poundage bow. I'm usually shooting at 40 pounds. So I had to, first couple shots, I had to see where they were hitting so I can compensate. But there you go. Not a bad group. And these arrows are going in. Sorry about that. Here's the one I shot at 20 yards, right where my finger's at is where it went in. So at 20 yards, it is penetrating pretty good, even with a tip on it like this. I'm shooting bullet tips for practice. So this is Charlie with an updated post to the primitive survival weapons, making a bow and arrow. Of course, these are factory-made arrows. You can make better arrows or good arrows as well. The arrows I used were kind of fat because I couldn't find any good strong ones. But you can use, if you're able to find river cane, cattail or something, you can make similar arrows that will get the job done. So review the original video of how I made it, and then you'll see by actually using it in the field that it will kill an animal. So this is Charlie, swordofsurvival.com. Stay prepared, stay alive, and come back often. Thank you.